Hi YouTube, look what I just got in the mail. The good folks at the Curios sent me this nice package here with all kinds of really cool goodies. But I can't cover them all in one video, so I'm going to break it up into several videos. But for this one, I think I'm just going to grab this colorful one right here, and today we're going to be talking about Dom's Neon Rubber Tip Graphite Pencils. Let's get to it. I'm really excited to get into all these goodies that I received, but we'll just do one at a time and I'll spread them out over several videos. But the Dom's Neon, like all the Dom's pencils, come from India. And so let's just examine the package first before we tear into it and see exactly what we have here. Okay, so we see it says Dom's Neon. We can see that a lot of the pencils here appear to be in fluorescent colors. And I guess that would be fluorescent neon colors. They're rubber tipped, okay. And we see the back of the package there. Focus, please. There we go. Rubber tip graphite pencils. And as usual, a disclaimer, I know that my fingernails usually get shown in close up and they're probably very scary for most of you. Maybe a health hazard. I apologize, but these hands do a lot more than just videos. I was out doing concrete. I create things with my hands that they just get raw. And, you know, not much I can do. I don't go in to have them manicured for videos. So I'm sure that most of you guys out there at least will understand. Garage hands. Yep. Anyway, now that I've thrown the disclaimer out there and you can try not to pay too much attention to the fingers themselves. See here it says, welcome to the beautiful world of Dom Sharp Minds. Enjoy the Dom's range of products with these precise features crafted for you to explore your creativity to the maximum. Sharp Minds. Yes. And you have a website there and some information here. Number one, lead with high quality graphite for dark and neat writing, which stays longer. As opposed to what? I don't know. Accurate bonding process. Softened and well-treated wood for smooth sharpening and longer shelf life, we shall see. And it meets international quality standards, which are, I have no idea, India's number one brand. I think they only got like one company makes all this stuff, right? I don't know. Inside this box, you're going to find 10 rubber-tipped pencils of 185 millimeter length and 7.2 millimeter diameter. Plus one Dom's crystal sharpener. All right, and there's all kinds of other details there, and there's a barcode if you want to scan it. Okay. All right, enough of that. I think we've pretty much examined this box thoroughly. So we're done. Thanks for watching. Oh, wait a minute. Sorry. I know. We're going to crack the puppy open. Huh. A little humor there. Now, I've been out of commission for a while. Now, I apologize. It's been a while between videos in recent weeks, but I haven't been doing so good health-wise. My lungs have been taking the brunt of this season's cold winter. So, it's kind of difficult to breathe and all that, but I think I may be recovering so that I can sharpen more pencils. And there's the crystal sharpener, Dom's. There's some yada, 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 yada. Same thing on the other side. And a barcode with more yada. And what do they call a crystal shimmer? Plastic. Yes. But it's pretty. Pretty blue. I don't see anything written on the sharpener itself. We'll try it out and see what we think about the sharpener and add it to my vast collection of pencil sharpeners. Kind of popped in my head. Hey, okay. I've been told the rubber bands do not come with the package. That was for shipping purposes, because to get them from there to here, they'll rattle in that plastic container it came in, and customs then would have authority to rip the package to shreds, which is what happened the first time they attempted to ship some goodies this way. All right, first impression, they're pretty. Yes, absolutely pretty. Let's just grab the neon green here, for example. And it says that it's an HB number 2 pencil. It's got a little barcode there. So this one here is kind of a, oh, kind of an apple greenish color. And the itself is also green. It has a black ferrule, as you can see right there. Okay, and then that's what the end looks like. Hopefully that shows up really nice. And they're round. So the thing about round pencils, they feel good to the hand, in my opinion, of course. But on a slanted up drafting board, they're coming down fast. Okay, they're going to roll. All right. Then you have an orange one with orange eraser, black ferrule, black lettering. They all have black lettering, black ferrule. So pretty much it's the paint job and the erasers that are color coordinated. And we'll test these all out. The pencil and eraser is what we'll test out. Okay. Just wanted to make sure that was clear. Well, we got this color. This color is the... this color. Yes. They're all HB number 2 pencils. What would you call this? Kind of a flaming pink? Don't know. So, it looks like I've got two oranges with orange erasers, orange paint, black lettering, two greens, two blues, and again, color coordinated erasers, they're blue. Then you got two flaming flamingo pink, or whatever color you want to call that. And then, last but definitely not least, we have a couple of yellow ones here with yellow eraser. The aesthetics I like. They're really, really nice. Very nice pencils. But how do they write? That we're going to test next. Okay. Since I'm not much of a flamingo pink kind of guy, I hope that's understood. I'm going to go with more of a... how about a green? It goes with my eyes. Yes. Sounds like a great idea. And we're going to need to sharpen it, so I'm going to bring the crystal sharpener over here. And of course, we need something to sharpen in. All right. It's like cracking an egg. Okay, here we go. Let's try out this sharpener first, and then I could always sharpen it with something else if it's not satisfactory. Okay, now it is sharpening really smooth. The wood is in fact very smooth, and the little bits that are coming off, as you can see, it's not like dried out shredded type wood material, but it's very smooth. Okay, there you go. And that's high quality. I really do like that. Now, I'm not expecting this to be a long tip sharpener, and it's not. Okay, move that out of the way. Okay, I say it's kind of chewed up the tip there a little bit. You can see it's not a solid, but looks very, very porous. The graphite. So I'm going to use another pencil sharpener. The pencil sharpener, I mean, it's, you know, it's just a freebie they just kind of throw in there. Nothing special. Okay, so I'll use a different sharpener. Just to, like this Cume sharpener, for example, where I broke the plastic cover on it already. That wasn't so great. Let's do it with this one here. This one I like because it has that stop right in here and everything. That's pretty cool. And yes, I have a video for all this. All right. All right, now let's see if we got a little bit of improvement there. Yes, so the sharpener did a better job with the Cume. That's why I have it. Now to get some paper here. I've already used some of this right here. Let's get an impression of what this feels like to write with this Dom's Neon. Okay, this is the Dom's. Is there an apostrophe? No. Okay, so Dom's Neon. It's an HB number 2 pencil. First impressions. Well, it writes smooth. Okay. It has very good tonal quality. It's like the darkness. You can probably see it pretty well here. Now, I'm writing kind of sloppy and fast here. Just because I just want to get a feel for this. Yes, it does go on very smooth. It's a very soft graphite. And because of that, I can tell you that you'll be sharpening it pretty regularly because the tip kind of wears down quite fast, as you can see. All right, which gives me an excuse to use a different sharpener for this next one. And I think what I'll do is I'll use this one here. This was the M&R, little brass jobby here. And it doesn't do long points, but it's a nice sharpener. Let me just get that to do its thing real quick. Okay. To focus there. So you can see it's not a long point sharpener, but it gave us a nice point. All right, let's see here. Dear Mom. It's been a while. Whoops. Misspelled a while. How do you like this pencil? All right. This pencil is really nice. It's a very, very nice pencil. I like it. I think it's a great pencil to draw with because it's very soft. It's got very good tonal quality to it, as I already mentioned, those two items. And just like a lot of my drawing pencils, for example, the tip tends to wear down fast because it's soft. So you will be sharpening this pencil quite regularly, especially if you get those short points. If you get a little more longer point, like I'm going to get with this Mitsubishi here, kind of hoping it'd stop sharpening eventually. All right, then that is a point. But will it last? I don't believe so. Due to the softness of the graphite, you are going to sharpen this pencil more often than a harder pencil. All right, and then I could already see that I'm wearing the point down, but I still have a little more to go. I could still write some more sentences here, you know, yada yada. But it's definitely a very soft pencil for an HB, and I find that very interesting. So why don't we find out how this compares to an HB from the Mitsubishi Hyuni grading system that I normally use. So let's do that next. Okay, now I got my light box right here, but before I do that, next thing we're gonna do is gonna create a shaded pattern using the neon, and then I will compare it to the Hyuni from Mitsubishi, which is how I compare all the pencils. This is the basis for my grading all the pencils in my videos. But to start off with, I'm going to need a tip. So I'm going to go back to sharpening this again, just to make sure I get it all the way sharpened. For some reason it just keep sharpening. The Mitsubishi isn't stopping for some reason. Don't understand. So I better stop because it's eating up my pencil. Look at that. That's all I got left, and I only sharpened it, what, 3-4 times total? That's not the fall of the pencil. That's the sharpening is kind of wacky. Anyway, that's another topic. So let's get right to this. This thing's going on pretty dark for an HB. Wow. Okay, well, that's the DOMS. All right, and we'll just zoom in here so you can see it better. But that goes on really dark, really dark. I mean, that's pretty cool. All right, now I'm going to start off with, since this is technically an HB pencil, it says HB. Okay, as you can see right there, HB number 2. I'm going to start with an HB pencil to compare it with. Okay, it's an HB. So I'm going to see how this thing compares. Here we go. Well, I think we're going to see this is a big difference here. Find out what it really compares with, because it certainly is darker than a standard HB, at least an HB in Japan. I could press on this really hard, but I won't. But I could, and I bet you I can't get it as dark as that Dom's. All right, well, that's an HB right there. Now, do I need a light box for that? No. It's clear that the Dom's is darker than the HB. Even though it is marked an HB, it is a softer, darker pencil. Nothing wrong with that. It's just, that's why I'm doing these reviews, so you can actually see what it's comparing with. So how about with a 2B pencil? Let's see if it compares more to a 2B. Let's do it. All right, that's a 2B. So, what do you think? There's a 2B, Dom's. 2B, Dom's. All right, there's a difference here. The darkness may be very close. The Dom's comes out looking darker because it really filled up those little white holes here a lot better than this one did. Okay, which means it's, who knows? I mean, it's got more, you know, graphite powder that's seeping down in there or what. It's usually the harder pencils can get down in there better than the softer ones. And that being a soft pencil, it certainly has saturated that. Let me try a 3B just for giggles here. Though it's, I guess it's getting kind of crazy here. All right, here's a 3B. All right, so let's see, how are we going to compare with a 3B? Let's see. Well, first impressions, it certainly seems to be more towards the 3B already. You can hear the difference too, which is interesting. Saturate as much as I can. Okay, and then I'll just do the Dom's here and get it up close. Okay, the Dom's is softer. And it really is going through the graphite a lot quicker. I'm wearing down the graphite quicker. So it's definitely softer. And take a look at that. On the left is the Mitsubishi 3B, and on the right is Dom's. Wow. Okay, you really can't call that an HB pencil. These aren't HBs, but I'm happy they're nice and dark and soft. They're just not HBs. Oh, wow. Let's put it underneath the light and magnify, and let's see what we've got here. That's as close as I can get right there. Wow. That's really, really tough. Okay, what you don't want to get confused here is that this one here, you can see more of the paper. This one here hides a lot of the paper, but it's the darkness of the graphite itself that I'm most interested in. The Mitsubishi on the left appears darker, like it's a more black on the parts that actually has the graphite. This has just better coverage. But when you look at it like that, it gives you the impression that's the darker one. But when you magnify it, look at that. See, the Mitsubishi 3B is blacker than the... That's what my eyes is showing. The left one is blacker. It just has more white showing through it. Interesting. So let's just try something else here. Let's lay down the 2B again. And the DOMS. Magnify it. Okay. So what do you think? The DOMS looks a little darker to me than the 2B, but here it doesn't, except for it's got better coverage. That's the only thing. I'm going to have to say that the DOMS is darker than a 2B and leave it at that. I can't really rate it a 3B. I don't think it quite makes it there. And it's got different properties too, in that the coverage is different. It just seems to fill in the holes of the paper better rather than skating across the tops of the paper fiber, which is the MB pencils do. So that's an interesting revelation there with these pencils. Put my Mitsubishis away here and move this out of the way. Here we go. All right. I've pretty much eaten up the pencil, but it was worth it so that I could put this video together for you guys. The DOMS Neon Rubber Tip Graphite Pencils. Wow, very soft. How does they erase? Let's try it. Time to scoop in again. Going to use the eraser on this pencil here. They definitely erase. Feels on the hard side, but it does erase. Of course, the darker you go. And here's another thing too, by the way. If you take a look, the darker the pencil is, you know, the softer a pencil is, the more it leaves behind when you erase, it leaves graphite. And notice that I'm able to get most of the DOMs erased compared to the Mitsubishi, which itself is telling me that the 3B Mitsubishi is on the softer, darker side than this DOMs is. So the DOMs more relates to the just to the 2B or above, I would have to say. And that's pretty good. All right. Let's see what kind of damage it did to the paper. Not too bad. All right. Well, there you go, folks. Good looking, round, playful, very soft, smooth, nice tonal quality, pencil tip retention is not that great because it's very soft, so you will be sharpening it a lot. I like the pencil, it's a really good one. Now the question is, which one do I put in my box? Because they're different colors. Maybe I'll just stick this one since I've pretty much used it up anyway for this video. Well, I hope you like this review. If so, please give me a thumbs up. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe. Should be a button somewhere down there. Leave your comments below and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.